stuttering, but don't look at me.
Just don't look at her.
Just fine, at her. I'll just look at... We'll be with you shortly.
Yeah.
We'll be with you right now with Lima on the Bayonetta, your Loki on the cloud.
Winner's quarters. This bracket is moving a lot faster than I thought it was, given
on winner's side it is.
Yeah, I was going to say, because I waited about an hour to play my loser's match.
Yep.
And
which is of no fault of our wonderful TO, Jordan Kowslack.
Right, we just also had YOLO bracket lasting until about... You know,
now.
10 minutes ago.
Yep.
Because everybody entered YOLO.
Oh, baby.
I'll talk about it later.
I don't know if I have or haven't missed this.
I have,
because Lima still shows me sick things all the time.
Ooh, okay.
And Yura Loki is one of my favorite players to watch that, like, doesn't get that shine that all of our others do, because A, he doesn't come out, and B, he's like... He's done really good things, but he's never made PR because I don't think he's ever been active enough for a season.
Never.
No. And we were just, me and Motocron were just talking about it. We think the last time we saw this actual matchup between Lima and Yura Loki was like last year during
intentionally drifted to ledge to cover Lima going to ledge because he knew he was going to retreat there to cover all of his lag. So he intentionally drifted for the ledge trump there. Like, Yura Loki has big brain plays. He's so calm and collected as well.
I love that play. He baited out the witch time, and then he turned into bat with it, which was the best case scenario because then he just down smashed Lima to take the stock.
I just like that it looks like every move that Yura Loki makes, he has a thought process behind it that you can tell what it is.
Yeah. Then again, he did room
with that SDI.
He did room with Aerolink for quite some time, so he does have a little bit of experience in this
matchup. Aerolink and Disco Bunny.
Yeah. Okay, not too opposed to the high recovery, but yeah, the guns right there.
Yeah, that was just like a really good snipe that most players are not going to hit. Most players are going to be afraid of that limit climb hazard. They're going to chill out. They're like, okay, I expect Cloud to grab ledge here. Mm-hmm. But not Lima. Lima's on that next level.
Nope. There's a reason why he's VGR'd.
I like that Yura Loki has just such a calm mind. Because, like, he got sauced on stock one.
Right.
And then he comes back and doesn't fall for the witch time off of Angel platform.
Yeah. Right.
Just gets a real solid stock.
Yeah. That's one of your Loki's best characteristics about him as a player, to be honest. It's just that he can... You can take his stock super early and you can style him, but he'll always come back.
I think Loki thought he'd get the snap on the ledge on that first climb hazard.
Definitely did. Wow. The timing on that back air just delayed enough to catch Lima dropping shield.
He's so good, my lord.
He knew that Lima was going to come out down with a button, but I think he just misspaced himself to be outside the range of that fair. Or maybe didn't expect Lima to drift so hard in.
Yeah. Lima definitely commits to what he's going to do.
Oh, yes. Because he believes in himself, 100%. Why would you not?
Yep, there it is. That's the invincibility attack that Lima will throw witch time at every time.
Ooh, this could be it. Oh, good DI, though, to not get back aired right back out. That would have put him in a really bad spot. Instead, just take the fair back into the center stage. Oh, empty off grab.
I think he held on to Lima there a little bit to wait for him to DI in a direction that he wanted him to.
Potentially mix up. Because there's a couple of ways the Cloud can throw you, especially from that center stage scenario. Because he doesn't get anything off of his combo. He doesn't get a combo throw. Okay, Lima.
Oh, and the Lima SD, the classic.
Okay, I like that. He shielded, waited a sec for the invincibility to come down, and then came back in for the grab.
Now, I want to know, why would he purposely up, though? Like, what's the whole point of that?
As Cloud?
Yes.
In this matchup, it's actually really good. So Bayo's landing sucks. She either has to commit to her specials and then eventually come down to special landing lag, or she has to air dodge, and her air dodge is terrible. Cloud eats it alive. She can jump away, but loses her jump and a lot of combo potential on, a reversal situation.
Right.